Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to share with you a story time video. Now, I was thinking about this the other day and I was thinking this would make a great story time. So if you're new to my channel, go ahead and subscribe and let's get on with the story time. So ever since I think I was 6, I've noticed something different when I eat fruits and vegetables. Starting out with fruit. When I was 6, I would always go to my friend's house and her favorite little snack was having strawberries and milk. And I loved that snack. I was so excited to go over to her house and know that that's what we would be able to eat. So we would make it and I would be eating and I would be fine. But then when I got home, I just kind of felt weird. I felt sick to my stomach. I kind of had a weird feeling in my throat. And I just chalked it up as I didn't know what it was. And I didn't tell my mom or any parent because I was 6 and maybe they wouldn't believe me. So as the years went by, I stopped eating that strawberries and milk because I just didn't like how it made me feel. But then when I was about 11 or 12, I remember my stepmom would make a fruit salad and I loved fruits. I basically can eat a few fruits. But there are some fruits that give me a weird reaction. So anyway, it was a summer day and she was making watermelon, grapes, apples, just a mixed fruit salad. And I loved watermelon. I mean, I loved all fruits. I mean, they're sweet and they're juicy, and especially on a hot summer day, they taste so good. Well, anyway, I was eating a lot of that salad, and then about an hour later, I just had to relieve myself of that because I got a weird feeling in my throat, and I had like a saliva buildup in my throat, and it just was the weirdest feeling ever. I never got hives. I never felt my throat closing up. This was just an odd feeling. So I stopped eating fruit. And I was thinking it probably is the watermelon because I ate a lot of watermelon that day. Well, so as the months went by, and even backtracking when I was maybe like 9 or 10, my stepmom would always put in our lunches a piece of fruit. She would either put an orange or a banana or green apples. And back then, I basically couldn't eat any fruits without getting a sick feeling. So bananas, I could not eat bananas. And oranges, even to this day, I cannot eat an orange. I can drink orange juice, and I think maybe I can eat those little cuties, but I cannot eat a raw orange. Anyway, I remember I was sitting at lunch and I wanted to have my orange, and so I thought, okay, I'll try eating it. And even the first little taste just gave me that weird, like, saliva buildup and to my stomach feeling. So I vowed never again to eat an orange. And back then I couldn't eat bananas, but now, thank goodness, I can eat bananas. So again, as the years went on and as I got older and started living on my own, I just kind of picked and choose what fruits I was going to eat and what I could eat and what fruits I need to stay away from. So I found that now I can eat bananas. I still cannot eat oranges. I can eat strawberries. I can eat all berries in the berry family, like blueberries, blackberries, raspberries. But I cannot eat cherries. And when I was a kid, again, my stepmom would make that fruit salad and sometimes she would add cherries to it or something. And I used to love eating those, but I realized that I would get that weird reaction. And with the cherries, I remember I was with my sister and she lived in Washington at one point in her life. And she lived by Mount Rainier in the state of Washington. And we went grocery shopping and she bought these yellow type cherries. And she said that they were from Washington and named after the mountain, Mount Rainier. So we went grocery shopping and we picked up these cherries. And I warned her, I said, you know, I get a weird feeling in my throat. And she goes, oh, just try it. So I did try it, and lo and behold, I could eat those. Now, I don't know if it was because it was from a different state or what. And let me backtrack. So when I was younger, we used to live in Pennsylvania. And I don't think I ever got that weird throat reaction when I lived in Pennsylvania. But in Minnesota, again, when I was little, when I was 6 years old eating those strawberries and milk, I lived in Minnesota. And I got that weird feeling in my throat. And then again, in Minnesota, we moved when I was younger, like 11 or 12. And that's when my stepmom made that fruit salad. And it was from Minnesota. So, I don't know. I don't know if it's the pesticides or whatnot. When I was older, about 20, I really wanted to try watermelon again. And I'm thinking, oh no, I'm gonna get that weird feeling in my throat. Well, there was one summer, I don't know if anybody remembers, but there was a yellow watermelon or like an orangish yellow watermelon. Well, anyway. And I prayed over my throat and I said, you know, I do not want this feeling in my throat anymore. I want to enjoy this fruit. And when I prayed over my throat, I ate that watermelon and I did not get that reaction, that saliva buildup or that sick feel. So I have not tried red watermelon since my childhood when I was 11. Anyway, so I make smoothies every day and I really try to be healthy and I really want to be able to eat fruits and vegetables. So I really just have to be careful of the fruits I eat. So again, I can eat strawberries, the whole berry family. I can eat red apples, but not green apples. I cannot eat peaches unless they're baked. I can eat pears if they're red. And I know it was like so complicated. I can eat apricots. I can eat pineapple. And I can eat plums. I think that's basically it. Oh, and I cannot eat any melons or muskmelons or, again, watermelon. Which is just a shame because I remember the taste, but ever since I got that reaction, I just stay away from it. So, with vegetables, again, when I was little, my stepmom in our lunches, she would make us like a sandwich with lettuce. And back in the day, you know, they didn't really have, dark green leafy vegetables, collard greens, or spinach, or kale. The only choice was iceberg lettuce, and that lettuce basically doesn't even have any nutritional value. It's just water. So anyway, she would make us lunches, and she would put that on her sandwiches, and I just always remembered getting that weird feeling with that iceberg lettuce as well. So to this day, as I'm an adult, I do not eat iceberg lettuce, and I would never, because it just has no nutritional value anyway. So with the vegetables, I noticed that weird reaction. The only vegetable actually besides the iceberg lettuce I've noticed that reaction with is broccoli. I can eat steamed broccoli or cooked broccoli or baked broccoli, but if the broccoli is raw, again, I just get that weird sensation in my throat and a saliva buildup, and it is kind of hard to swallow, I guess, as I'm thinking about it, and just that weird feeling in my stomach. So I just stay away from broccoli, I mean, unless it's cooked. I actually made a while back, if you want, and I'll leave the link below on how to make a broccoli pizza. So go ahead and check that video out. But anyway, again, as I said, I make smoothies and vegetable and fruit smoothies. So I am so, and I basically now, since I am kind of putting two and two together of the allergic reaction feeling, I call it, is I do think it is pesticide related, because when I eat organic, I'm too scared to try an organic peach or an organic watermelon. I just, you know, once you have that feeling, you just clench up, and I'm never gonna try it. Or a melon, I don't think I'll be brave enough to try those fruits. Oh, and I can eat grapes. I can eat red and black grapes, just not green grapes. So when I do go fruit and vegetable shopping, I like to go organic. And I am so thankful that I can eat abundance of vegetables. Again, all collard greens I can eat. I can eat spinach, kale, Brussels sprouts, carrots, peas, green beans. Fresh green beans from the garden is so good. Squash, potatoes, yams. I mean, there's probably obviously more vegetables I'm just not thinking of. But anyway, so I just thought I would share with you that quick little story time. Leave in the comments below and let me know if you guys are allergic to anything, any types of fruits or vegetables or any foods that you try to stay away from. And I guess I can tell another related food allergy type little mini story time. When I was in high school, I think my family was eating shrimp, and I think I tried it, and so I know I definitely am allergic to shrimp, because I tried it and then I went to go take a bath and like my hands swelled up and I think my face swelled up, and I went to bed and my stepmom goes, "Oh, just go to bed, you'll be fine." And you know, thank goodness my throat didn't swell up. So to this day, I just stay away from shrimp, and I don't like fish, really. I don't like the taste of fish. It's bony, it's just from the ocean, it just tastes fishy. I like tuna fish from the can. I know it's not that good for you, and I don't eat it all the time, with a lot of mayonnaise. And I used to like fish sticks, but I got food poisoning from eating fish sticks one time, and I used, and actually it was kind of ironic because I bought them at an organic food store, and I used a lot of tartar sauce, and maybe it was my fault because I don't think I baked them long enough, but now I stay away from fish sticks. And as far as vegetables, I just do not like tomatoes. I can eat cooked tomatoes, but I just do not like the taste of fresh, garden-picked tomatoes. Oh, I should. Everybody thinks I'm crazy, but I just don't. Oh, and I can eat zucchini. I like zucchini. But I do not like cucumbers.
I think tomatoes and cucumbers are the only vegetables I do not like.
And I'm not, as far as I know, allergic to them. I might be allergic to the cucumbers because, again, I get that weird feeling in my throat. So I just stay away from those. Anyway, there's a plethora of fruits and vegetables that I can eat. Go ahead and check out my last couple of videos. Speaking of fruits, I did make a how to make a chia seed fruit popsicle. So I would really like you guys to go ahead, and I will leave the link below and I'll leave it in the description. Please go check that video out. I spent a lot of time on that video and I think it turned out quite well, and they turned out really nice. They taste great. So you guys can go check out that recipe and go ahead and check out this very last video I did, my tea collection. So anyway, guys, thank you for watching. I want to thank all of my subscribers. Leave in the comments, you know, what videos you guys want me to make. It seems like it's kind of like a free-for-all. There's not really, you know, one type of video people are making. It seems like people I'm noticing are kind of branching out on their own, which is good. They're not copycatting or doing, you know, a nighttime routine all the time, or, you know, they're being a little bit more individual. And so that's what I want to do. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I will see you in my next video. Okay. Vegetable.